beautiful day, everybody. Let's make beautiful memories one episode at a time. And today is definitely a beautiful episode because I have somebody who belongs to a very beautiful family. She is also beautiful herself. I've been involved with this family for many, many years in many, many ways. But we will not get into that anymore. But please welcome to my YouTube channel, Dani Barretto and her husband, Camilo. And her husband, Javi. Hi!
Hi, Tom!
Oh, di ba? Magkano kami ang marriage counsel?
Ito talaga yun.
No. Why is Javi here? Because I think he's made such a difference in her life. And I think one of the things that we want to show here is to show how things can be healed if you're married to the right man.
Yes.
If you somehow have, you know, improved your relationships. Well, as you know, Dani is the first child of Marjorie with Kier, right?
Yeah.
Yes. I guess how old was your mom when she had
19.
You?
She was 19.
And your dad was how old?
Probably 21.
Oh, so
22.
That's super duper young. And did you know your dad? Did they live together for a while and bring you up? Or
for what I know, they were separated when I was born. Oh, okay. They were my boyfriend, tapos they were separated when I was born. But he was there when my mom gave birth.
Ah, okay. So was he a big presence in your life as you were growing up?
Not so much. I knew of him. He would parang come and go in my life for 27 years. Come and go in my life, but not like a constant figure. But I always knew who he was. Like, I knew he was my dad.
When you come for your birthdays and things, special occasions?
Yun yung no. I don't think I actually ever celebrated a birthday with my dad.
Okay.
And growing up, that was actually a major frustration for me. Kasi syempre, when you have friends, tapos you see at their birthday parties, di ba? Yung parang may cake blowing, tapos complete family pag birthday, ganyan. So I had that. I didn't have that growing up. But it wasn't naman much of a bubog. But yeah, with my dad, we had a relationship naman. Parang I have memories of him. Hindi naman total nothing. I do have naman. Good and bad memories.
So did it hurt you that he wasn't part of your life? How did that affect you?
Yeah, of course it did. Because like I knew he was just around eh. Parang I knew that hindi naman siya OFW, hindi naman siya like, he's just within my reach. You know, I can ano him. But when I got older and like I had more freedom na to reach out to him and see him, I did. I tried.
Oh.
I reached out to him, and at one point I actually lived with him pa for 3 months when I was 19. Yeah,
is that good?
It was like a very dark phase in my life. At the time, I wanted to get to know him.
Mm-hmm.
Parang I wanted a different point of view. Okay. Parang I've lived with my mom all my life. Parang I wanted naman to try to know my dad. So I lived with him for 3 months. Tapos, we had fun. Dun ko nakilala yung dad ko. Parang we had a relationship. I have great memories of him. But naudlot siya eh. Parang after 3 months, dun kami nagka-falling out.
Biko, what happened?
There was a fight. A fight occurred one night. And hindi na namin na resurrect from that night.
Oh.
We just stopped talking after that fight. And then it has been 7 years.
And you haven't spoken to him?
I spoke to him last year. Mm-hmm. I called him.
Mm-hmm. Because you were worried about him over Christmas.
A lot of things. Parang because I also had a baby.
Mm-hmm.
And I was very emotional because of course I knew he's just there and I want my daughter to know him. Diba? Para I don't want my daughter to grow up na what if she asks me about my dad, wala akong masagot. Because I don't know what's happening with this life. I didn't even have his number. I had to ask for his number sa lola ko, his mom. So I called him and then we spoke. Tapos we kept trying to plan to see each other. But because of COVID, hindi kami matuloy-tuloy.
So when was the last time you saw your dad?
My dad? 7 years ago. Right?
7 years ago.
Seven years ago.
So from what I hear, so the Barretto family, this is the, you are the strong one.
Yeah. Well, I would.
How was your relationship with Tina Julia, Chloe?
I'm really an ate to them.
Okay.
Like I thought I'd be a cool ate, but I'm super overprotective with my siblings. I'm actually a bit stricter than my mom. Cause ako yung nakakakita sa kanila eh, when they go out, or ako yung chaperone. So ako yung no, hindi mo pwede kausapin yan. No, wag mong lapitan yan. Ako yung ganun. And my mom would always tell me, can you calm down?
So yung ganun sa akin.
Yeah, like calm down, let her. Like, my personality is, I think, way stronger than my siblings talaga. I'm more, ano ba?
You're very firm.
Yeah, I'm very firm. And more aggressive, in a sense. Because my siblings are so sweet. And so,
so
you know.
So really sweet. Like, yeah. They're just like asukal.
Yeah. Overly. Clingy.
Really? Yeah. They really are. And you're not like that.
I'm not. Okay. I'm less affectionate. So, I show my love.
Did your mom have a hard time with you, oh, do you yeah. think?
I was a very hard child to raise. I was a prodigal daughter. Lagi ako naglalayas. Ako yung very confused in life. Like, laging may issue sa school, laging may issue sa life, issue sa friends. I was that kid. So my mom had a really hard time with me. I gave her so much problems talaga. Kaya ngayon pag may hinihingi yung mommy ko, okay mom. Alam mo, I'll give it.
Kasi parang ka bumayin.
Nung... Ay, ito na.
Ayan, kaya nandito si Abby kasi siya
nag-tame sa akin.
Nag-tame sa kanya. So, when you met her, did you see an angry girl? What did you see? How did you meet the two of you?
We met by accident, like a long, like 4 or 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Five years ago because I was in La Union all the time. Mm-hmm. And it just so happened when I was there, she was there, but I've already seen her before. And that I felt like that was very serendipitous because, like, I didn't get to talk to her the first time I saw her, so. A year later, I saw her.
So when you saw her, parang cute siya.
No, I knew she was because I already found her cute the year prior to me seeing her.
May double chin pa ako nando. May double chin pa ako nando. O taba, de, payat pa naman.
So when I saw her, I instantly knew that, like, that's her. That's the girl I saw. Mm. So I told my friend and I'm like, I'm not gonna let this moment pass where I don't meet her.
And I did. Wow, naman. Ang haba ng
hair. Haba ng hair ko kahit hindi
naman. Ikaw, napansin mo ba yun? When you first saw you, did you see him?
No, you know, I was actually seeing someone at that time. Hmm. So, nung pinakilala, nung when we met, it was okay. Hindi, I remembered his name, but I went on, like, doing my thing in La Union.
Napakilala ka ngayon kay Dani.
A friend of mine introduced us. Then, from that day on, then I asked her out.
Well, after our first date, di na kami naghiwalay.
Yeah, I saw her every day.
Every day na kami magkasama after that.
And it wasn't even planned. It's more like, I'll see her today. Then the next morning, she's like, I'm having a bad day. Can you visit me? I'm like, okay, sure. Yeah. Then we were both having like a lot of bad days at that time.
5 years ago, I was a very dark, you know, in a dark place in my life because I just got out of a very toxic relationship. Mm-hmm. I was with a person for almost 5 years. And it was very abusive. Mm-hmm. So when we broke up, I had like a dark phase that I didn't know what to do next because my routine was changed, tapos my life was changing, and then para I blamed other people instead of myself. So nadama yung mom ko, nadama yung lahat. So I decided to leave. And then when I left, I lived with my grandma, my lola, my dad's mom, because I'm very close to her.
Oh, okay.
So at the time, that was when I met him. So yung hindi ko nakikita yung family ko nung time na yun.
And you really missed them?
Yeah, I really did. Like, I was, because my we're very close. So me being away from them for like, I think that was 4 months, that was really hell talaga for me. Super hell. And
why wouldn't you just go back? I'm sure your mom would.
I was very ma pride.
Like, you were. Yeah. I hope I hear the word were.
Yeah, I admit that. Like I said, I can't go back. Umalis na ako eh. Ganun yung utak ko nung time na yun. Kailangan ko panindigan to. I was very ma-pride.
You saw her in her dark place.
Well, she told me that she was going through a problem and what all of that. But I didn't want to get into detail because given that I was still trying to like get her to like me and all of that stuff, I kind of didn't want to put her in a situation where I had to agree with everything she said. Mm. And I'm not the type of person to be like, no, you're right. Mm. I realize that, like, you know, you may have had your reasons for leaving, but at the same time, like, you need to, like, parang do damage control with what you left in the past. Like, with what happened to your siblings, your mom. So I didn't do it in one go. I really studied her. I never judged her based on the decision she made. Because everyone has their reasons then. So when we got to the level of our relationship, when we were more comfortable with one another, I told her, like, you know, I really feel like you should patch things up.
Yeah, like, he told me it's time.
Not just because you're seeing them doesn't mean you have to kneel and say sorry. It's more of just being present again. You do it gradually, not in one go. Then she did.
Galing. Yeah. I mean, no, I love the way, is this the way you guys fight? I mean, obviously.
Yeah. We don't yell at each other. Cause that's why I always say he tamed me because my emotions are always heightened. I always yell, I scream before. It's really a different person. But mahihiya ka kasi yung pag yung kaaway mo hindi kasi sinisigawan eh. Yung parang hindi kayo magkasing level. So parang ikaw, okay, I have to tame myself. So he taught me how to actually fight ng maayos. Yung we can argue lang, we don't have to yell, we don't have to say hurtful things.
So, you can discuss.
Yeah, you can discuss.
So that's, girls, maghanap kayo ng gaya katulad ni Javi.
Yeah.
Understanding, respectful, and wants ano?
Wants family. Mm-hmm.
Talking about family, so when I met you, you had a concern, physical concern, right? Which was your
double chin.
Your double chin.
Yes.
So being a family of people who almost look perfect.
Yes.
Anything, a lot of them, I mean, different ways.
Yes.
Like, I cannot say Julia's more beautiful than Gawi. Yeah. I cannot say,
different
parang,
beauty
all
talaga.
Different
eh.
Beauties, but they're all beautiful. How did, and this chin of yours, did it affect your self-esteem?
Ay, diba, Doc, I made you kwento before, na parang, it before, it really didn't affect me so much. But I think it was the people that made me insecure of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yung, the one thing that didn't really bother me so much before, the since everybody kept picking on it, I started noticing it more, and then I became insecure. So parang I absorbed it.
They can do that to you.
Parang now the power of social media, like how they can affect one's confidence. Sobrang dali. It's easy nowadays to just shut down someone's confidence. And people.
Or somebody is so strong.
Yeah.
How did like, that happen?
Diba they always say na pag magaganda yung kapatid mo, then you tend to compare yourself to them.
Mm.
That never happened to me because my siblings always showed me a different kind of respect.
Mm-hmm.
That I should never ever feel that way. So that was never an issue. And then people always say, bakit ganon? Yung mga kapatid mo, ang ganda, ikaw hindi. So parang ako nung una,
okay, never mind. People actually say that to you.
Yeah, or like, Barretto ka ba talaga? Hindi ka mukhang Barretto.
Grabe.
So, and I always say that and I was like, ano nga bang itsura ko compared to them? So parang bigla na ako napaisip, bakit ang dami? So ibig sabihin, ang dami nakaka-notice nito. So, then that's when I started to get bothered na about it.
Oh, and this was when?
Parang, I think this was when my social media presence became medyo mataas na yung parang
so
I was
you
making.
Were already together.
He was there na.
Okay.
I was
and
making
you saw
a,
it happening.
Yeah, I saw it happening, and I just I was more shocked that like people have this power over you. It's like I have this this saying that I follow, like don't throw stones and hide your hands, but social media gives you the power to like throw all the stones and you'll never figure out who this person is.
Yeah.
It's just very hateful, and I just didn't like how even no matter how confident you are or how strong you are, sooner or later it will get to you if you're having a bad day. And it just hurt me to see the person I love being affected by this. But I couldn't tell her that it was wrong. But
di parang nahiyaan ako at one point mag-picture ng sarili ko sa social media, sa vlog ko, parang nahihiya na ako. Kasi sa vlog ko, I never put makeup on eh. Hindi ko talaga gusto nagme-makeup unless I have to.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos I started to become more ano with myself because I wanna hide something na, you know?
Mm.
Angles, I had to figure out my angles because it's just hard na parang, alam mo yung doc na parang you feel beautiful today, tapos pag nag-post ka ng picture, everybody will tell you otherwise.
Wow.
So, masha-shutdown ka na parang...
Why didn't you stop mag-vlog?
I told him I had a face that I wanted na. Na parang it was being such a hateful environment na it's not positive anymore.
Why do you think people do this?
A lot of people would say it's out of their insecurities, but I don't think it's that eh. Parang nowadays, I feel like it's just out of spite na lang. Parang
may malalang.
To make themselves feel better.
Parang may gusto lang silang i-prove. Or I don't know, kasi hindi mo naman hindi ka nila kilala, di mo na naman sila kilala. So it's not out of meron silang feelings towards you. It's just that they wanna ruin your day. They just wanna say it.
Well, okay. Diba? So that's what I'm trying to prove to people also, that looks do matter. That's why I put up Belo, really, because people think I put it out of vanity, up for vanity. But I was also bullied for being ugly when I was a kid, made fun of. I'm adopted to say so. People will always say, kaya ka pinamigay kasi ang taba mo at saka ang pangit mo.
Grabe.
And this is like 5 years old. I mean, wala akong social media doon. Salamat naman sa Diyos. But it was my classmates. Kasi parang adoption is like before, I don't know now if it's like that. But parang they look down on it. Parang pinamigay ka talaga. Bakit? Are you that bad? So I really vowed then that I would devote my life to making people beautiful.
Oh,
and by making them beautiful, they would feel better about themselves, and then they would be more self-confident. Mm. Yun ang gusto kong gawin.
Yes.
So when people attack me and say, ay, you're so all about vanity, parang,
alam niyo kayong maganda, hindi niyo naiintindihan kung anong feeling ng mga, thank you, it's a small thing. It's a double chin, right? Because your nose is beautiful, your eyes are beautiful, your lips are beautiful, but unfortunately, you had extra fat.
Can
I just say that it is a bit of a weird double chin? It's not my normal. Sorry, ah. Parang, kasi most people have a double chin. They have extra, parang may chin sila.
Yes, ako wala.
Yung sa'yo, wala ka sa yung baba. So parang nag-double step talaga. So,
si Doc Bella na po nagsabi niyan.
Pero matagal na ko nang pinag-observahan si Dani. Yes. Kung ganda ng bata, ng batang to bata, bata ka sa akin. So, nangigigil ako dito. But you know, I was just seeing on pictures and that's two-dimensional.
Yes.
So, I couldn't really tell what I could do.
Yes.
Anyway, so finally I got to meet you. What did we meet ba? Was it for that?
No? I think it was Julia's birthday. Tapos okay. I met parang I told pa my mom, Mom, I know she can help me. Help me talk to her. So my mom brought me pa to Doc Bello. Kasi it was, Doc, alam mo ng time na yun, desperate matters ko na yun. Kasi sabi ko sa sarili ko, hindi okay lang, I'll just let it be. But when I saw you there, sabi ko, I think this is God's way of...
Oh, diba? From God.
Pinupush na ako ni God na ayan na, nilapit ko na sa'yo, lumapit ka na. Sabi ko, I really need Doc Bello right now. Kasi parang... changing na how I do my content because of my insecurity. Yung parang
it's affecting your life
talaga.
Yeah, it was
really affecting
you.
Na my life, my confidence.
Okay, so we decided, so we met finally,
yes.
And we looked at her face, and really everything's fine. It's just this part, the lower part, which is something that people usually ignore.
Yes.
You know, people always have their noses done, which you didn't need.
Yes.
Or sometimes their eyes done, di ba? Pero bihira sila nakakaisip. Yeah. But now with social media, because every angle is important and you have to look good on the side, on the front, then it was time.
Yes.
So we finally did her liposuction of her chin. How long ago was it?
About a month ago.
Month ago. So in the beginning, how was the whole experience?
That was such a grabe, you know, like roller coaster. And I was so nervous the day, like days leading up to the surgery. Mm. And then finally on the day, I'm just so excited to get it out. Yung parang I knew my life's gonna change after this.
So
and
did it change?
It really did, Doc. Like,
why they're not making up? They don't say anymore. In your
now life. They notice. Now they actually think. Mm. Pumayat ako because my face got smaller. Pumayat naman ako, but it's not my face got smaller because of the lipo talaga.
Ah, okay. It's, and by the way, we also did her arms.
Yes!
Yes! Kaya naka-backless na po kami
ngayon.
Siyempre,
mapakita ko
pero
na.
Pero of course, yes. Maganda ang arms, pero gaganda pa yan. 2 more months. Kasi a liposuction settles after 3 months. Were you worried? You were encouraging? Anong role mo dito,
I was very, like, when she told me she wanted it done, I didn't tell her no. Because I mean, at the end of the day, who am I to judge what will make her happy?
Mm-hmm.
You know? So I was like, do it. If you really feel
and
like...
Hindi naman ako magpapaiba ng face.
Yeah, then she would, like, she would tell me, like, should I, before, like, should I not? Then I remember the day we met you, she was like, this is my chance.
Mm-hmm.
Then one day, mid-pandemic, she was like, I'm getting it done.
Oh.
Sa videos talaga, Doc, nakakadiri. Yung parang pagka nakikita ko yung sarili ko, tas... It ang saya ng face ko pero nagsasalita din yung double chin ko.
Kaya ibang tao dito sa mga
tao dito. So sabi ko, okay, this has to go. Kasi parang for me, kung if there's something that's bugging you and you know na pwede mo naman siyang palitan, pwede mong tanggalin, pwede mong ibahin, you can. Like, people are not gonna frown upon something that will make you happy and that shouldn't affect you anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Like ako after this, I'm pretty sure a lot of people will say things na parang hindi natural or whatever. The thing is, this is actually how it should look.
Right. Eh, wow. Maganda na ako ngayon. How about you?
Maghanap na kayo ng bagong pang-bash kasi wala na ka double chin. Dok, nasabihan ako may thyroid problem.
Oh.
Yeah.
Mahaba ang baba. Ito nga ang problem. Wala akong chin. Nilagyan pa ni Dok.
Oh, so naglagay kami ng taba dito, right?
Yes.
We got some fat to put it here kasi... Mas maganda nga yun kasi it's your natural filler, di ba? And I think, did we do anything else?
Parang this, here pa also, you put fat also.
In the temples,
yes.
Okay. So, sa dami naman ginagawa namin, no?
But,
no, it took me, you're challenging for me because it was really not a normal chin. I don't think, no matter how thin you would get, I don't think that was gonna disappear.
Yes.
It was of a different thing. So, she had another chin here. But no baba, so it's a short. So we took out the fat here. By the way, this is not the final result, ha? Kasi meron pa siyang matigas dito, so I know it's going to keep getting better. But we also have to make dagdag para maganda ang profile. Pakintingin nga ng profile.
May jawline diba? Na ako. Binigyan ako ni Doc Bella ng jawline, guys.
Okay, so lahat to, magapa to. Pero pag nawala na to, ang ganda-ganda, ito na lang bone ang makikita. It's only been a month, so as I said, it takes about 3 months. Kasi yung katawan mo, pag nalipo, gaganon siya, parang, huy, ginulo mo ako. Yeah. And it will be hard. And so if you touch Lani's chin right now, it's hard. And then over, you have to massage it a lot. Press lang. And then you put warm compress.
Okay.
Just so the blood will circulate, so that it will relax. When did people start noticing?
I started, nung nag-heal na yung face na wala may bruises, I started doing my Instagram stories again, tapos posting, and then people would message me na, pumayat ka, like, nasa na yung double chin mo, wala na. Parang sabi ko, guys, as much, even if I wanna say na diet lang to, ginawa ko na lahat ng diet, hindi talaga siya nawala. We really needed to take it to the next level, and it's gone.
Oh, is she happier? What do you think?
Super. Like, my friend, like, so we see our friends, all of that, and she wouldn't tell them what happened. So when they see her, they're like, something
like, changed.
You look really good. Something's different. So of course for her, it's like, I'm not the only one that noticed it. Mm. You know, so she's so much happier now. Like, and I always compliment her all the time. But like earlier when she was getting her makeup, then I was looking at her and I was like, you have a jawline. Like, you have, like, I see it. And she's happy. And for me, like, that's of paramount importance. Like, her happiness.
Parang you have to take back that power that the people took from you, eh.
Okay.
Parang I gave the people so much power. Now I want to take it back and say that, you know, I did this not for you. I did this for myself.
I don't know why if they make other people feel less than. They feel more than.
They more, yeah.
But I don't think that's the way it should work. We should all more than each other.
Yes.
You know, support each other. True. Especially women are the number one. But it's not the men.
Yes.
It's the women who put each other down so much. So, yeah. So I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
So
though,
is there anything you want to share with everyone about this experience and how they can learn from
it? I think just don't overthink. Don't, huwag niyo muna takutin yung sarili niyo without actually knowing. You go to the clinic, to any Belo clinic, and magpa-consult. When I talk to the doctor, ask them the whole process, and I promise you, it's not scary. The healing process is fast. And kasi when you hear lipo, agad feeling mo masakit eh. But it's really not. Like, just don't be afraid. Take that risk, because it's super worth it.
Well, I can see the happiness in her eyes. I can really see the twinkling eyes. And Javi, you are the most wonderful husband. I wish all husbands were like you. You know, you're so blessed.
That makes you feel so beautiful.
You lang pala. Ay, wala akong gagawin sa'yo. Anyway, thank you for sharing your story, Dani. And I wish you the best. And I know now that you will fly higher. And on that note, I hope you had enjoyed our beautiful episode. Stay safe, everybody. And don't forget when I say this, because I'm always, to follow something.
Okay, please do like and subscribe to Doctora Vicki Belo's YouTube channel.
Yes. Stay safe, everybody. God bless. Bye.